teď jdu zápasit o titul v největší, nejlepší české organizaci. Porazit Piráta a získat titul pro mě znamená získat cenej skal. Ukázat se českým fanouškům, který mě neznají. A Carlose Vemolu dostat do kouta. Jsem úplně ready zbít Piráta. V Oktagonu je nový král.
Zdeněk Polívka, versus Robert Bříček. Zdeněk Polívka, mladá puška, která bojuje celý život a mierí na velké vítězstva vo svojej kariére.
Ten svou přestívku Game Over doslova a do písmene naplnil ve svém posledním zápase proti Ericu Spicelymu a veterána UFC nejenže ukončil, ale ukončil také jeho kariéru.
Rozhodně tohle byl Game Over, velký návrat do té střední váhy. Táborce dobrého kola, ve kterém Polívka trafil dobrou pravou.
Robert Bříček za skore 12-4, polský strelec, který je obávaným bojovníkom polskej aj domácej scény. Robert Bríček, ktorému sa nedá odoprieť jeho boxerský background, je to vždy vidieť v jeho zápasoch, aký má fantastický prehľad v rukách.
Polský bojovník, ktorého sme znali veľmi dobře z Veltru, ktorý už šahal po titulové šanci s Davidem Kozmou, ale možná myslel na titul až příliš brzo, protože duel s Britem absolutně nezvládl a společně se svým týmem se rozhodl přestoupit právě do střední váhy.
No Robert stále má před sebou jediný cíl a to je pás šampiona Oktagonu. Rozhodně přijde silnější, lepší, připravenější.
Střední váha nabídne fanouškům v Pardubicích doslova a do písmene bombónek.
So next up, we move to the middleweight division, and here we welcome the Poland wrecking ball, Mr. Robert Bříček. Now, the story of this fight, Jan, is the fact that Bříček is coming off the back of that loss, that devastating loss to the Brazilian Kaique Brito, but now is making the move up to middleweight, which we think is the right move. Yeah, you look at his frame, to see him walking around.
It gives you that huge confidence boost, and like you say, from now on, I think that he's gonna believe in himself, believe in his punches, and tonight, Polívka will be a huge test for Bříček.
Yeah, that win against Eric Spicy wipes away the memory of that loss to Abdulrahman. He lost that by Kimura, basically made a mistake in the takedown, ended up with pretty much it set, and he was frustrated. He said that concentration wasn't there. But take that loss away. Take that loss away. He's on a superb run of form. His performance against Tomczak, for me, really stood out as well. His cardio, his technique, it was all there.
He was all there. Yeah, like you say, he won 5 out of 6.
Yeah.
And just that Kimura loss.
And just one little lapse of concentration took that clean run away, but he is rebuilding and he is on a run of momentum. I mean, he fought on the last card and he is fighting again. Let's get this underway, this middleweight contest. Let's hand it to Andrei Novotný.
Je před námi další zápas ve váze do 84 kg. Vaším rozhodčím v oktagonu je Jan Voborník. 3 kola po 5 minutách, pojďme si představit oba muže. Nejprve Modrý roh. 31 let, 185 cm, 84,25 kg na váze. Akademia sportu Valky Vilanou, Impact Bělsko-Běla pod trenérem Miroslavem Oknínským. Má na svém kontě 16 zápasů, 12 vítězství, 7 ukončení a 4 porážky. V rámci Nerudova poháru za Tip Sport Team, za Polsko v modrém rohu, Robert Bryček! Červený roh, 23 let, 189 cm, 84,3 kg na váze. Cage Warrior z Říčany, pod trenérem Jiřím Čibičiberou, má na svém kontě 10 zápasů, 6 vítězství, z toho 3 ukončil před limitem a 4 porážky. V rámci Nerudova poháru za HN Group a za Česko v červeném rohu, Zdeněk, game over, Polívka!
Guys, you know the rules. Follow it on time and accept my comments, okay? Fight fair, fight hard, and always for win. If you want to touch glass, do that and go back to your corner.
So we're set and ready for this middleweight contest. Robert Bryček stepping up to middleweight in the blue corner, white shorts, taking on Zdeněk Pavlivka in the black shorts, red corner. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Me, Brian Lacey, alongside Jan Malach, calling the action for you here at Octagon Prime 4. Touch gloves.
Okay, let's go.
And oh, Pavlivka is the underdog here against Bryček, despite the fact that this is
his division. Strong outside leg kick.
And look at that. There's, to say that he fought a welterweight, there's no difference in size here between the two. He doesn't look outsized whatsoever against Pavlivka. Oh, nice jab there.
Yeah.
Bryček has that boxing background, very good hands. Still trying to find their range, each of them, just the first 45 seconds though. Pavlivka taking the center of the cage, keeping the Polish fighter on the outside.
Yes, he's all center, yeah. And for middleweight, those combinations are pretty quick.
Very quick hands. I think he certainly caught Eric Spicely by surprise. What I liked about that performance as well was the choice of shot. He didn't just headhunt, it was working the body, opening up the head.
But when I look at Pavlivka, he looks strong, not physically, but mentally focused. Man on a mission.
He started martial arts age 13. Has a silver medal in the European K1 Waco tournament. I love his quote when he's asked about what fighting means to me. He said, this life found me. I had no choice but to be a warrior. Fighting is living. Says a lot about that sort of samurai mentality, doesn't it?
Yes.
Maybe need a bit of that in my life. Eating is living for me.
And bench pressing.
Of course. Bench pressing baguettes, that's pretty much it. Two donuts on the end. Get your reps in. This is very technical, this.
I think that Polivka's biggest advantage over these other middleweights is the... Oh! That right hand landed, and I don't know if that left hand landed.
Bricek, good head movement, yes. Alexander rolled underneath that one.
But the biggest advantage that Polivka has over these other middleweights is that speed, how he can cover the distance.
Oh, nice overhand right there from Bricek.
Oh!
But look at that, soon, there's no gap for, air for Bricek. As soon as they exchange the angles out, the cage has been cut off instantly by Polivka.
Look how far Polivka is right now. Long distance, jab distance. Just a kick. You see, he's even from that distance, he's dangerous with his rear hand, with his right hand.
You see the welts on the outside of that lead leg of Bricek as well.
Yeah.
And on the, if you look at the right side of his torso, the liver there has also been lit up a little bit.
But right now, Bricek is finding his rhythm. Right now, he's the one who's holding the center.
It's been all striking so far between these two. I'm quite content to duke it out in the middle. Oh, heavy right.
Oh, another strong outside leg kick for Polivka. Another one. He's going to take its toll.
Oh. Oh, 10 seconds of this opening round. Nice step in left there from Bricek.
Oof, finally a checked kick by Bricek.
Good first round. Heavy leather being thrown from both sides there. Early in the round, Polivka looking to be controlling the range, getting some of his shots off, but you can see there some blood from the nose of Polivka. Bricek seemed to turn it up a little bit in that last minute, Jan.
Yeah. Maybe he wanted to return a favor after those outside flat kicks.
Yeah, there's one of them.
Yes. Look at it, Bruce. Bam, another one.
And all tests on the feet, not one sign of a takedown, a clinch, even a level change between the two.
Carlos Vemola in attendance.
Yeah, absolutely gutted at the news that Kristofic fight has come off the card. Octagon 30, December 30th. Sure there will be an announcement
right after
soon.
This fight.
Right after this fight, yeah, and that's slick, isn't it?
Big announcement.
Polivka in front in the tip sport odds. Round two underway. Bricek in the blue corner, Polivka in the red. They're both having their moments in the first round, Jan. What do you want to see more of from Bricek?
From Bricek, hold the center, not to move around that much in a circle. Stand your ground.
And Bricek, we talked about his boxing, but he's also a high level Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu brown belt, European champion. That's not an easy task to get, especially in that bracket. working that lead leg on the inside this time.
Working the lead leg inside, outside, working it.
And even if they're not heavy kicks, that they all add up, right? It's all just attacking those nerves, building up the damage bit by bit. Oh my goodness, look at that.
Look at that.
Octagon 29. What do you say? Cosmo versus Bookinger. The champ, champ, champ. Is that what he wants to be? My goodness. Ivan Bookinger. What a guy stepping up to take on Cosmo for that welterweight title. That lead leg is in trouble, Jan. You can see the movement is slowly getting compromised by Bricek.
I think that Bricek should go for the takedown.
There's a big difference in the approach this time for Polivka in this second round. It is smaller shots with the hands and just work on that leg. Watch whenever he gets a chance. He'll either start or finish a combination with that leg kick. That was heavy. Oh, look at that head movement. Ducks under the right hook as Bricek steps in.
Ooh.
Cup kick, yeah.
Unintentional.
Bricek barely blinked. Stoic Polish look. The clock's been left running, so that will be wrong now as this time's back in. Oh no, that was the 5 minutes he would have got. My apologies. Now we are right, 2 minutes 23. Bricek on the front foot. And that, the reason that is so effective. Oh, uppercut from Bricek. And he needed to do something to get some respect. Like I was saying, that the reason that's such an effective kick, the outside kick, the shin to the thigh, is that sciatic nerve runs all the way up the side of it. If you deaden that, you compromise that movement. Look how red that leg is. I hope his hotel room's got a lift to get there.
Nice timing on the knee by Polivka.
Bricek is still dangerous. You saw that little short uppercut. Left or right hook combination. Now he's picking up the pace.
Ooh, beautiful head movement by Bricek.
He's showing no signs. I mean, slightly slowed down on his feet movement, but digging to
punch to the body.
Right to the liver as well. And this is good from Bricek, right?
Another one.
He needs to mix it up and swapping that target from the head to the body. That's a good little tactic.
1 minute left.
Still, we're now 9 minutes 30 seconds into this fight and there's not been one single takedown attempt or even clinch yet.
It's interesting. But how many kicks can Bricek take?
Yeah. There is a point, right, where even if your head is still in it, your leg will give up. Those nerve endings will be so damaged.
Look at that head movement by Bricek.
Also these shots, I do like the way he switched it. There's our first takedown attempt.
By Polivka.
By Polivka. Wow. Really intriguing battle between these two. Pretty much a boxing stroke kickboxing match so far, bar that one little takedown attempt from Polivka. But that damage, look at the leg. I can't even see if they're getting any ice on that leg. But just try and describe to people, Jan, what those leg kicks feel like, what, how it compromises you in the cage.
First, I don't want to say exactly three kicks, but it's like, okay, adrenaline kicks in, I won't feel it, it will be okay. But fourth, fifth, and sixth, it's okay, something is wrong with my leg.
Yeah.
And then from all of a sudden, you can't move. You want to move, but you can't. It's not. It's like you're not controlling your leg. So I know that Bricek is a warrior, but once that leg gives up, it gives up.
And we have five more. Oh. Even the guy cleaning the mats is a showman here at Octagon. Now we're underway. 5 minutes, potentially 5 minutes left in this middleweight contest. What I did like in that second round from Bricek, and he did it at the end of the first round as well, he started to up the output a little bit more. He needs to take the front foot right. I know it's his front leg that seems to be compromised, but he needs to go first. But Polivka, look at this, again starting strong in round three.
Wow. And still explosive. Good 1-2 by Bricek.
Oh, again.
Good.
Again.
Good.
Tonight there's been a number of fights where you've really got to give credit to the tactics, whether it's the team or the fighter coming up with these approaches to take on these opponents. It's been fascinating to watch some of these matches unfold so close, and the game plan's been a key part of them. Those leg kicks from Polivka, very, very interesting. They're seeming to take a toll now in the third round.
Would you expect coming into this one, would you expect kickboxing match?
Not at all, not at all. Again, it's one of those fights where I think Bricek would have liked to keep it standing as it has been, but I thought Polivka might have mixed it up a little bit. But so far we've been, and I will say that this, with all honesty, treated to what has been an exquisite technical stand-up battle between these two.
But just think about how huge a takedown would be in this fight.
Oh, without a doubt.
Oh, good combination by Polivka.
Still sharp, that jab. And you think it's Bricek that's coming up, you'd think he would have the speed advantage coming up to middleweight. It's hard to argue that when you see the speed and the accuracy of the jab from Polivka. Oh, nice head movement again.
Again.
Matrix-style stuff from Bricek.
Plus, it takes away a lot of Polivka's cardio, punching the air.
Yeah, you might imagine not connecting with a shot. You don't use the energy, but you still do, right? You throw it as hard as you throw it, and that's still the gas tank going down. That energy meter. Oh, and nice stiff jab again. And as much as we've complimented the leg kicks, the jab for me as well has been good from Polivka, but you've got to say Bricek's having his moments, because it's the bloodied face that he's facing in the...
Ooh! What was that, a slip?
Not sure.
I think that Bricek was right. Although Polivka hit him on the forehead, I think that Bricek was right.
Oh.
8 seconds left.
This round has gone quick. Oh, that overhand right, that was lovely, beautifully timed by Bricek. Now dig into the body again. He seems to come on strong in the last 90 seconds, Jan.
But again, that head movement after his straight right hand, Polivka answered with that left hook, and Bricek just ducked under it.
Seconds left. Bricek walking around Polivka. Still taking those leg kicks. It really hasn't done as much to the movement as Bricek as I would expect when you look at how red and damaged and welted that leg is. Bricek pushing the pace at the end of the round. 10 seconds to go.
10 seconds.
Great finish to a superb bout between these two. Wow. Tightly contested.
I wouldn't want to score this one.
I would not at all. Bricek. Sorry, Polivka doing the lap of honour. His demeanour says he feels like he's done enough. And let's look back through some of this, Jan. Talk us through this action.
Oh, good right hand by Polivka. I want to see that head movement from Bricek.
Yeah. Really was exquisite. There was about a four punch. Here we go.
Wow.
There we go.
Wow.
Take a bow.
And Polivka was missing by millimeters.
Well, we shall wait and see. The scores are being added. And there you have the stats. My goodness. What do you make of that, Jan?
I don't know, because total strike 68. I've seen like at least one third being missed by Polivka.
Well, I think the scores have been counted. We are set and ready to make this announcement, make this bout official. Will Bricek's move to middleweight be a victorious one?
Viděli jsme fantastický zápas, potlesk oběma mužům. Pojďme se podívat na to, jak tento duel viděli bodoví. So let's see how the judges score this fight. All three judges score for the winner 30-27, 30-27, 29-28, 29-28 and 29-28, 29-28. Vše pro vítěze, all for the winner, kterým se stává Zdeněk, game over, Polivka! Tak Zdeňku, neuvěřitelná gratulace obrovská, fantastický výkon.
Děkuju moc, prosím tě, kde seš, já vidím trošku trojitě. Ten uprostřed, dobrý.
Nikdo asi nečekal, že si to s Bričkem rozdáš uprostřed oktagonu v postojářské bitvě. To byla taktika, nebo se to prostě najednou stalo?
Taktika byla, rozhodně jsem si představoval, ale lepší průběh, třeba, že ho ukončím v prvním kole, ale Robert je fakt rychlej a tvrdý bojovník. Kolikrát mi tam zasadil úder, že jsem chviličku... No, ale vyšlo to a je to, ty vole, já nevím, co k tomu mám říct.
No tak je to další životní vítězství. Potom, co si ukončil kariéru Erika Spicelyho, málo kdo ti věřil v tomto zápase s Robertem Bričkem, ale ty jsi to vzal, šel si do toho s otevřeným hledím a předvedl si, že v tom postoji se taky neuvěřitelně lepšíš.
Byla to třetí příprava po sobě, takže jsem rád. Díky bohu, že to takhle dopadlo. Jsem totiž už kurva unavený.
Po druhém kole jsme slyšeli v tvém rohu, že tam jsou velké obavy, mám pocit, o pravou nohu. Dokonce Jan Voborník se ptal, jestli to znamená, že končíš nebo pokračuješ. Můžeš nám k tomu něco říct?
Při nějakém tom low kicku, tak se mi podlomilo koleno. Tak jsem se leknul, chvilku jsem couval, ale radši to odpajdám, než abych to vzdal.
Děkujeme moc, Zdeňku, fantastický výkon, další posun žebříčku. Tvoje výkony se neustále zlepšují, jsme moc rádi, že tě tady máme. Český bojovník, Zdeněk Game Over Polívka.
Díky!
Ještě samozřejmě dáme prostor Robertu. Robert.
For me this is a joke. Look at his face. His trainer talk to me. The judges. His trainer. Look his face. He throw more light kicks, but I always punch him.
Wielki shit! Gówno!
Okay, it's your opinion. You have to talk with the judges. I can do nothing about it.
It was significant strikes. Look at his face, look at me. Face, leg, what is worse?
Podívejte se na mě, jak vypadám. Podívejte se na můj obličej, na moje nohy, co se to tady děje, to je vtip.
What do you think?
Okay. Thank you, Robert. V každém případě fantastický výkon, Robert Bryček.
Těžší už víceméně z toho divizi jsou.
Krásná pozice pro Davida Korelovny. Jak to je konec?
Kozma se znovu vyšmykl. Tak to je neskutečné. Celá hala stojí.
Titul OKTAGONu mi nikdy nevezme.
OKTAGON se vrací do nejtvrdšího města republiky.
No a teď je samozřejmě na řadě otázka, proti komu bude Kozma obhajovat.
Poprvé v historii MMA se šampion dvouváhových kategorií pokusí o to, co ještě nikdo před ním nedokázal.
Já jsem zápasil na celém světě, nikdo mě nepoznal.
23 submisí má na svém kontě Ivan Buchinger.
Buky je zpäť, kámo, tohle je zvíře.
Půjdeme dolů, já si myslím, mám jeden opasok, tak chcem ten druhý.
A další tvrdá prava, tak to je neskutečné, loket. A novým šampionem je Ivan Buchinger.
Mr. Kozma, možná, že přijdem.
Legendární Ivan Buchinger vyzve nespochybnitelného krále a dosud jediného šampiona této váhy. Davida Kozmu. Růžový panter je v oktagonu s 9 vítězstvími bez jediné porážky.
Když já vyhraju, tak to bude trošku ostuda, že mě porazila 6-6.
Kozma ještě zasahuje tvrdou levou a je konec.
Ale nemal ještě zápas Buky.
I kdyby já si mi přibíral, tak prostě v té váze není zvyklý. A ten zápas půjdu 100% vyhrát.
Vím, že já jsem ten, kdo může získat ten třetí opas.
A chybět nebudou. Ostravští rodáci, Matěj Kuzník, tvrďák Jan Široký a bývalý titulový vyzyvatel v těžké váze Daniel Dittrich. Vítězové reality show Octagon Výzva Karol Ryšavý a Roman Paulus. A v neposlední řadě zápas, ve kterém to opět bude osobní.
Z nějakého toho kamarádstva už se upustilo během 5 sekund.
Kdybych měl umřít, když by měl být diskvalifikovaný, on nevyhraje v Ostravě.
Ostravar Arena. Poslední lístky v síti Ticketportál a živě na octagon.tv.